वी ऑल लव मूवीज, वी सेलिब्रेट सिनेमा, वी आर बिग फैंस ऑफ हॉलीवुड, बॉलीवुड, टॉलीवुड, aren't we? What if I say same movies were responsible for the discovery of radioactivity and the radioactive element? You will be surprised, but that is true. India's first movie was showcased in the year 1895, and that movie was shooted on a photographic plates. Same kind of photographic plates were responsible for the accidental, yes, accidental discovery of the radioactivity and radioactive element. Isn't that great? By the same year, 1895, Rongen has discovered X-rays. And Henry Becquerel was trying to find out whether there is some kind of connection between the X-rays and the rays emitted by the phosphorescent material, those materials which glow in the darkness by absorbing the light. While studying those phosphorescent material, he happened to place uranium salts accidentally over the photographic plate, which was covered by an opaque paper. That photographic plate was fogged. Later, Henry Becquerel showed that rays emitted by the uranium was different from the X-rays, as these rays could be deflected by the electric field and magnetic field, unlike the X-rays. This was a major breakthrough. Shortly after this, in our story, enters a lady who is today considered as mother of modern physics. Yes, none other than Madame Marie Curie. She started her experiment with uranium to study the nature of this radioactivity. The term coined by her, yes, the term radioactivity is given to us by Madame Curie. Soon, she was joined by her husband, Mr. Pierre Curie, in her work towards understanding of radiation. In 1903, something bad happened as Madame Curie was not considered for a Nobel Prize in physics for being a lady. Such a shame. Discrimination on a ground of gender inequality. But Mr. Pierre Curie stood by her and refused to accept the award, as the major contribution was from the side of Madame Curie. Later on, the jury had no option but to announce trio as a winner of this award, that is Henry Becquerel, Mr. and Mrs. Curie. Thus, a history was created when Madame Curie became a first lady to receive a Nobel Prize in physics. This experiment led to a groundwork for a new era in physics and chemistry. Eventually, this would lead to a discovery of neutron. Madame Curie continued to investigate the properties of the radioactive elements. This led her to discover two new elements, polonium and radium. This in 1911 won her second Nobel Prize, this time for her work in chemistry for discovery of polonium and radium. Thus, not only Madame Curie became the first woman to get a Nobel Prize in physics for her work in chemistry, but also she became first individual to get two Nobel Prizes, one in physics and other in chemistry. Hats off to her, a big salute to her. Do you know, within few years of their discovery, people started selling radioactive elements as a medicine, claiming that they are good for health. For pain and swelling, they sold radium pendants. For strength and overall well-being, they sold radon mixed water. For arthritis, they sold uranium blankets and towels. For good digestive system, they sold thorium tablets. This nautanki was carried out for quite some time. Innocent people also gave a good and overwhelming response to all this. But today we know these materials are very, 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 very dangerous for our health. Henry Becquerel died on 25th of August 1908 due to some unknown cause. But on his skin, innumerable traces of burning was found. The reason for this burning must be radioactive radiation. Not only this, Madame Curie also died due to this deadly radiations. She died of aplastic anemia, a disease in which production of blood in our body ceases or stops. When she died, her body and all her manuscript were contaminated with radium-226, the very element she own discovered. According to CSM, the half-life period of radium-226 is 1600 years. So this contamination will produce harmful radiations for so many years. Hence, visitors to her library are expected to sign a liability waiver and wear a protective gears made up of lead before entering into a museum in which all her belongings are stored. Her body is believed to have become radioactive and hence placed in a coffin which is lined with nearly an inch of lead. So strange! After understanding the background and the history of radioactivity and radioactive elements, we are all set to start a new chapter from our physics textbook, that is radioactivity, a part of modern physics. So see you all in my next video lecture where I am going to talk about radioactivity. And I am sure if you watch this video, your concept of radioactive will be very crystal clear and you will come out in your examination with flying colors. And finally, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification button so that when I upload a next video, you get a notification of it. Bye!